In this video, I'm going to explain another example for the orthogonality of the subspace. So the question that we have is, we are given a matrix U, which is 1, 2 and minus 1. And W is a set of all the vectors in R cube, which are orthogonal to U. So we are given that information and we need to find the basis of unit vectors for W. Right. So I'm going to denote the inner product on R cube like this. So you have this bracket and dot. This is basically the standard inner product notation. So I'm going to write W, which we need to find, which is V in R cube, right? So we are given this W, and we are given V in R cube, and you have U and V, which is zero, because we are given that this is orthogonal, right? So now let's take the vector. So we are taking the vector x1, x2, x3, v as x1, x2, x3, because we are given that this is in R cube. So it's going to have three components. Dot product u and v. So u is 1, 2, minus 1. So the first value is 1 into x1, 2 into x2, minus 1 into x3, and that should be equal to 0. So this again basically is of the form some a x bar equal to 0, right? Okay. Now W, we know that it's going to have three components, x1, x2 and x3, and this is just going to be again x1 plus 2 x2 minus x3 equal to 0, right? So from here we can see that there is a matrix which looks like this, 1 2 minus 1, right? And we need to find the row reduced echelon form for the null space. And from here, this matrix which comes from these values 1 2 and minus 1, we can see that this will be the pivot column, because this is 1, whereas these two are going to be the non-pivot columns, because it is 2 and minus 1, right? So this pivot column will be the dependent variable, whereas this non-pivot columns are going to be independent, right? So how to find the basis? So I'm going to write this equation, x1 as, taking these two factors on the other side, minus 2x2 plus x3. Right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let one of the independent variables, so these are the independent variables, I'm going to let one of them be 1 and the other as 0. So you have x2 and x3 here, which are independent. So I'm going to first assume x2 as 1, therefore x3 becomes 0. And as you can see in the next part, I will assume x2 as 0 and x3 as 1. So we'll do that part later. So with this assumption of letting x2 equal to 1 and x3 equal to 1, now I'm going to write W1. So W1 is first going to be minus 2, 1 and 0, right? Because x2, when x2 is 1, then what is going to happen to x1? And when x3 is 0, what is going to happen to x2? So when you put x2 value and x3 value, you're just going to get x1. And we already know what is x2 and we already know what is x3, right? So from here, with this W1, we can calculate the value of modulus of W1, right, or the distance of W1. So we have W1 square, which is nothing but the inner product of W1 with itself, right? So when you do that, you will have root of, you're going to have minus 2 square plus 1 square, which is 5. And then once you get rid of the square, you're just going to have root 5, right? So this will give me the inner product of W1. Now from here, I'm going to get the distance or the other matrix for W1, which is nothing but this value divided by the distance or the inner product for W1. So I'm calling that N1. So that is nothing but minus 2 divided by root 5, 1 divided by root 5 and 0 divided by root 5, right? So now let's check on N1, because I've done this value divided by root 5. The inner product of this should be equal to 1. So when I do that, n1 square, it is nothing but minus 2 by root 5 the whole square, so 4 by 5 plus 1 by root 5 the whole square, which is 1 by 5 plus 0, and that turns out to be 1. So once this value of n1 is 1, then I know that my answer is right. Right. Next, now I'm letting the now I'm flipping the variables. So x2 as opposed to 1 is now 0, and x3 as opposed to 0 is now 1. And once I plug in these values in that particular equation, I can find x1. So x1 turns out to be 1, x2 is 0 and x3 is 1. Now I find the value of the inner product for W1. So W1 square will be 1 square plus 1 square, which is 2. Therefore, this should be W2. And therefore, W2 turns out to be minus plus root 2. Similarly, now I find N2. So this should be N2. So N2 mod square should be 1 by root 2 the whole square, 1 by 2 by root 2 the whole square plus 0 by root 2 the whole square plus 1 by root 2 the whole square. And once you do that, this answer turns out to be 1. So I know that I'm right on both ends, right? So then I know that since this N1 and N2 are 1, what are going to be the basis? The basis is going to be N1, this particular value. This is going to be the first basis. So I write this in the form which I found here, minus 2 by root 5, 1 by root 5 and 0. And the other basis is just going to be this, right? So you have 2 by root 2, which is 1 by root 2, then you have 0, and then you have 1 by root 2, right? So now can we have a check whether these are orthogonal or not? So I'm going to take the matrix U, which is given to me. So this is the matrix U, 1, 2, minus 1 initially. And then we're just going to multiply it with the basis, right? Finding the inner product. So U is 1, 2, minus 1. So U is 1, 2, minus 1. And N1 is minus 2 by root 5, 1 by root 5 and 0. And once you multiply them, the answer turns out to be 0. Similarly with U and N2, when you multiply, the answer turns out to be 0. Therefore, I can say that these are orthogonal vectors, and therefore these should be the basis for the matrix which is given to us.